Darren Wilson graduated from Regent University Film School in 2004 with a master's degree in screenwriting. But when he was hit with his first case of writer's block, it would take more than a master's degree to get him writing again.
I remember turning to my wife and one day, and I just kind of asked her, I was like, I need a new idea because this is driving me crazy. And she said, well, why don't you ask God for an idea? And I just said, God, if you have an idea, I'll take it. That was like my prayer, you know, really religious. And 5 minutes later, I'm downstairs furiously scribbling the basically the core idea for what would become Finger of God.
Finger of God is a documentary about miraculous events occurring in Christian charismatic circles around the world, an idea that at first Darren approached with skepticism.
I mean, I grew up pretty like straight-laced evangelical, like God's very normal, church is normal, everybody's normal. Anybody who's abnormal, everybody who's like doing anything outside of the ordinary is like suspect. I didn't want to make a movie about weird stuff. I wanted to make a movie about the real God, which is a normal God.
For several months, Darren refused to move ahead with the film. Eventually, his wife and father convinced him to go to a prophetic conference in Toronto. In the middle of worship, a pastor made an announcement that had Darren rolling his eyes.
He says, I just want everybody to know that an angel has just entered the building, and his name is Breakthrough. And I'm thinking, this is insane. Like, how does this guy know that an angel entered? How does he know his name, where he came from, blah, blah, blah. So anyway, he finishes with like, well, we'll just keep worshiping Jesus and we'll just let Breakthrough do whatever he wants to do and just keep worshiping the Lord. So I'm like, okay, whatever. And then I see this figure like right over here. And I can see him with my eyes closed. I open my eyes again and I can't see him. I close them, I see the outline of his figure. He was the most intense individual I've ever encountered in my life. Like just crackling with intensity. And I could see that his hands were like clenched. And I remember thinking, like, this guy wants to break through a wall. And that's when it clicked. I'm like, oh my gosh. And he said, are you ready? And I finally said, yes, ready for what? And he stared at me for a minute and he said, make that movie. And then he moved away.
For the next 2 years, Darren traveled around the world filming miraculous events. But all the while, his skeptical nature questioned what he saw.
Is this really of God? Because I'm filming a lot of weird stuff. I'm seeing gold dust, and I'm seeing manna appearing in meetings, and I'm seeing, you know, my aunt and uncle get gold teeth, and I'm like, I don't even know what to do with this stuff. I don't know where to put it. Their lives were getting transformed for the better, and really realizing their identity in Jesus. It's really weird, and it sounds a lot different from the God that I grew up with. But at the same time, when I look at the fruit, it looks like the God that I find in the Bible, which is a God who loves people and will get donkeys to talk to us, to turn us around. I realized about halfway through making Finger of God that this was not really a movie about miracles. Miracles are great, they're wonderful, we can't live without them, but in the end, it's love that drives everything. It's love that drives the miracles. It's love that drives who we are.
The film was released on DVD and to Christian television networks. The response has been overwhelming.
I've got thousands of testimonies of people that emailed me that tell me like they were healed while watching the movie. Nobody even prays for them and they're just healed.
Darren is following up the success of Finger of God with his new film, Furious Love.
It's going to be the film that defines like my life. It's the film I was put on this earth to make. My hope is for this to be the Jesus film for the church, because it's really a call to wake up and to start to walk in what we're supposed to walk in, which is love. It's the only weapon we have against the darkness. It's the only weapon we have against the devil. It's the only weapon he can't fight back. All we're called to do is be the hands and feet of Jesus. And his hands and his feet went to set the captives free, and they went to heal people, and they went to bring freedom. And that's what we're called to do.